Does anyone need a few small seconds? Contestant number two, Atul Patel. Atul Patel, cut the knot. Cut the knot, Atul Patel!
Go on, Atul! Go on, Atul! Go, Atul!
Rebecca Wilton was 27, intelligent, gorgeous, and hot. I was 22 and not. Somehow, we got on. And in a bar, one night, after several shots of cheap tequila, she pounced on me. OMG. And then she cupped my face and said, let's get out of here. Absolutely, your place or mine? No, let's get out of here. Let's get out of this country. Let's go traveling. Let's go to Europe. Let's go to Asia, to South America, to anywhere but here. I had dreamt of these locations as a child on TV. And in that moment, I thought about eating curries in Calcutta, swimming in the Seychelles, and smoking a joint in Jamaica, man. The very next day, reality hit me. What about your crummy job? What about your loser friends? Has reality ever stopped you from pursuing your dreams? I didn't have the courage to get on that flight with Rebecca. And on that day, God forgive me, she grabbed my arm, tears streaming down her face. It's not too late, come travel with me. The only traveling I was gonna do was back on the Gatwick Express. I waved Rebecca and my world adventure goodbye. Contest chair, fellow Toastmasters, most welcome guest, not traveling in my 20s with Rebecca was the biggest regret of my life. What about your regrets? What's your regrets? If you had to live your life again, what would you do differently? Okay, because regrets don't happen immediately. They transpire over time, and they crawl and creep up on you, and soon they build, and they feel like a knot in your stomach. At 30, maybe you regretted not traveling. At 35, maybe you regretted not having a more stable career. And at 40, maybe you regretted not having children, and now it was too late. At 41, I regretted all of those things. I was broke, divorced from my first wife, and living back at my parents. And then my reprobate best friend, Alec, took me out for a beer. And I poured my heart out. And I said, if only I had traveled. If only I'd worked harder. He looked around and said, you loser. Mate, you're fat. You've got nothing to lose. And then he grabbed and he got a paper napkin out. And he said, write down your biggest regret. I wrote down, not traveling. And he said, cut the knot. What do you mean? He said, look, cut the knot. If you cut the knot, what are you left with? Traveling, right? That's what you have to do. That is your calling. So, write down all your regrets, cut the knot, and that is your calling. Do you know what? That was the most intelligent thing he'd ever said in his life. I'm not going to tell you it's easy, but because of cutting the knots, I get to marry the most incredible woman over there. And she blessed me with two incredible children. Thankfully, they were both at bum-wiping age. And by cutting the knot, we travelled to Bali, and we travelled to Sri Lanka, and in fact, just last week, we were swimming with the turtles in Mexico. Anyway, what about you? What's your regret? Recently in New York, a blackboard was erected entitled, "What's Your Biggest Regret?" And within minutes, that blackboard was filled by passers-by. It was words not spoken, dreams not pursued, action not taken. So what now, if I were to give you a hanging? And whatever you write on there, the answer will be staring you right in the face. You simply have to cut the knot. And if it's, I need to spend more time with my family, cut the knot, spend more time with your family. And if it's, I need to start a business, cut the knot, start that business. And ladies, if it's not asking that gorgeous hot man out on a date, cut the knot, ask me out. So, in conclusion, how can you lead better lives? Write down your regrets and cut the knot. You can live a better life. Or you can wait. And you can wait. And you can wait until the cancer of regret grabs hold of your life. You decide. Contest change.